With 1,463 wheel horsepower, 2,111 pound-foot of torque, at over 100 psi of boost, Scott Birdsill's Ford F1, all the way from 1949, has been a crowd favourite here at Pikes Peak International Hill Climb. Despite the second-hand and slightly rusty-looking bodywork on this F1, it actually houses some fairly modern technology, the basis of which is a NASCAR-style tube-frame chassis. This is predominantly tube-frame, but does use some of the factory chassis rail components as well. This allows a completely modern take on the 49 pickup truck with modern suspension components to improve the handling. This is important because Scott uses this truck for a variety of reasons, including circuit racing, road driving, and top speed events. It's actually clocked an unofficial top speed of 178 mile an hour. While the bodywork is impressive, it's really the engine powering this truck that's the key to its appeal and its performance. It starts with a Cummins 5.9 litre common rail diesel engine. As we can see, it's also fitted with a pair of Garrett compound turbochargers. Scott changes up the turbo specification depending on the event the truck is entered in. Here at high altitude at Pikes Peak, it's running a 58mm and a 78mm Garrett GTX series turbocharger. The compound turbo system provides around 40 psi from the primary turbo, followed by an additional 60 plus psi from the secondary turbo. This adds up to in excess of 100 psi of total boost pressure. Now, holding an engine together with over 100 psi being pumped through it is obviously no mean feat, and in this case the Cummins diesel engine has been fitted with just about every top shelf component you could think of. This starts with a set of MAHLE steel pistons, which sound unusual if you've come from a petrol or gasoline based background, but in the diesel world steel pistons offer significant strength advantages over a forged aluminium product. These are fitted to a Carrillo H-beam conrod, and interestingly enough, the factory steel crank still remains. To improve reliability of the bottom end of the engine at such high power levels, a billet steel girdle is fitted. With a compression ratio of 20 to 1 as well as 100 plus psi of boost pressure, holding the cylinder head onto the block is one of the key concerns with engine reliability. Here, Scott is relying on a set of ARP 14mm custom age 625 head studs. With any engine producing this amount of horsepower, getting the tuning absolutely correct is key. In this case, the factory Cummins ECU is actually retained, which might be surprising to some, and it's been reflashed or retuned using the HP Tuners software. This allows complete control over all of the calibration tables inside the factory ECU, and despite the fact that this engine is now producing several times what Cummins ever envisaged the factory engine to produce, the stock ECU is perfectly sufficient for this purpose. With any engine producing this sort of power level, getting a constant supply of fuel is essential. The fuel system in this truck starts with a rear-mounted fuel cell, and there's an Airdog 200 gallon per hour lift pump that pumps the diesel fuel forward to the main mechanical fuel pump. This mechanical fuel pump is a Dynomite Stroker CP3 pump. It's capable of producing 26,000 psi of fuel pressure in the common rail. Of course, a larger set of injectors have also been fitted to supply the amount of fuel needed to produce 1,400 plus wheel horsepower. Now, despite the bodywork here on this Ford F1 coming all the way from 1949 and looking pretty much like a box, it's actually also incorporating some really modern touches with quite an extensive aero kit. It's actually also been developed with the aid of CFD. This includes the front splitter, a full carbon fibre under tray, a rear diffuser, and a triple element rear wing. Unfortunately, Scott's truck has suffered a failure here and couldn't compete in exhibition on race day at Pikes Peak. Despite this, it's still gained a huge amount of interest from the spectators, and we really look forward to seeing it run in the future.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.